Hey, I'm Torrance, founder of Teak & Twine, a gift box company here in Washington, D.C. And today I'm going to be showing you guys how we actually package products into our boxes so that when they ship, they don't all get destroyed. So something we take a lot of pride on here is that the photos that you see of what our gift boxes look like, we want that to be the exact experience that our customers get when they open the gift box. We want everything perfectly in alignment, definitely not broken. I don't even like it when stuff is crooked. And so we've developed this system for how we do that, that really helps keep everything looking beautiful. And I wanted to show you guys how we do that. So I'm gonna start with the crinkle paper out because usually we can put the crinkle in and then we kind of build the nest and place the products inside. But if you know you're making a box with something really big, you're just gonna be digging so much. So sometimes when we have a product that's as big as this one, I'll actually just put a little bit of crinkle in first. See, it needs a little bit more because my goal here is for this coffee to be up completely flush with the edge of the box. You might as well have the box helping you keep everything put together. And so the goal here is for everything to make one even flat surface with the top of the box. I'll push it down a little bit. That is exactly what I want. And now that is gonna make designing the rest of this gift so much easier. I'm gonna tell you guys right now, I just grabbed a bunch of products off the shelves that are different shapes and sizes so that I could show you how we put in every single kind of product. The end result is not gonna be that pretty. I'm gonna tell you that right now. But it will show you how we handle any kind of product situation here. So there you go. Now you're ready to design. So as I'm looking at all of these different products, the first thing I wanna put in is the biggest thing. Because if you put in a bunch of products and then last you put in a big one, you're gonna have to dig a big hole and that's gonna move and ruin everything. You're gonna end up doing double work. So let's bury this one first. Okay, when I first started out, I would just kind of dig with all of my fingers. But what happens then is the crinkle not only goes everywhere and spills out, but actually crinkle, you see it's crinkly like this. And as you were digging aggressively with your fingers, it straightens out. And then you have these strands of crinkle that are kind of sticking out and they don't look good at all. It creates a really messy look. And stuff isn't packed in as tightly because you basically end up creating a hole that looks more like this, where stuff can move around, rather than a really compact hole for the product. So I use two fingers on each hand to open up this spot. So you see here, I'm gonna do it right here in the beginning, and it's pretty hard work. I gotta get in there, and then you know, you can kind of use all of your fingers here in the end, and I make a hole that's just for that spot. You want to actually have to, you shouldn't be able to just plunk the product right in. If you can do that, your hole might be too big and it's going to be able to move around during shipping. You want to actually have to place it into the hole. It feels almost surgical when I'm doing it. And now this, that's not going to move around at all. Next, let's do this soap. So you're kind of thinking about the shape of the product where you're about to place it. I'm gonna put it right here. I'm gonna use those fingers and I'm gonna open up this hole here so that I have to actually put it from here to one side. Then if you see my fingers here, I'm just moving the crinkle out of the way enough to place it in there. That means that the crinkle paper all around this soap is really compact and tight. Nothing is going to be able to move around when I'm done with this guy. So now I have this really breakable glass. And a lot of people ask, do I use bubble? I actually don't. Unless I'm dealing with something super, super, super breakable, like a champagne glass, I just use the crinkle because it works. If you bury it correctly, it does not move around and the stuff really does not break. So I know I'm gonna put it right here. And now you wanna be careful here. If this gets broken, where is it gonna get broken? It's gonna get broken from here on the side, right? So you wanna be sure as you're burying it that you're leaving that barrier of crinkle between your product and the outside edge of the box. The other way something gets broken is actually inside the box. So even if you've got that nice barrier of crinkle, if I put two, you know, glass things right next to each other here and they're touching, or there's only a little bit of crinkle, now they can knock against each other and actually break each other even if there's no outside force. So when you're designing things, this box would have two glass things in it, which is absolutely fine, but you just want to separate them and put things in between them that aren't made of glass. So I'm going to put this right here just for aesthetics sake, although like I said, this box, not my favorite design work for sure. So for this one, kind of try to get in there and again dig down deep while maintaining the integrity of this little nest that I'm building, so it can go in there. Then I push down the crinkle here and I say, okay, now I'm gonna add some more. You basically want to fossilize your products in crinkle so that they cannot move during shipping, because guess what? You can put as many fragile stickers as you want on the outside of your boxes, they're still gonna get thrown around. So it's on you to package your products in such a way that they'll be okay. I was talking to a FedEx rep once and he said, if you can't be at a standing height with your shipping box and drop it on any of the edges of the box and have it be okay, then you probably need to rethink your packaging, because it's gonna happen. So now I've got this little cube where I'm just gonna make this little nest. Now, you know what? Let me try doing it wrong. So I'm gonna kind of just dig aggressively like this. Okay, and then, you know, dig a big enough hole to put it in. Now I've got a ton of work. I've got these stringy crinkles hanging everywhere. I've got this hole that's loosey-goosey. I'm gonna have to do a lot of work on the back end, you know, making this right and adding more crinkle. It's really hard to bring crinkle that's already been mushed back to life. Because it does get flattened, but you know, as much as you can, you would want to just barely be able to slide it in. Now, let's put this one here. Yikes. This box, again, not my favorite. And you know what? This just can't work here. This is too close to this. The coffee's too big. I'm gonna have to redesign this entirely. But we're just gonna leave this blank here for now, and I'm gonna show you how much tweaking I do to this crinkle before I would end up sending it on its way. Because you don't want a situation where you're sitting here kind of perfecting the crinkle for 10 minutes on every single gift before it goes out the door. That is just not scalable or efficient. So that's probably good. Here's the thing. You're gonna be annoyed by crinkle paper here that's kind of sticking up, and you're gonna wanna just push it down and fix it. But guess what? This box is packed so tightly that actually by the time you end up closing everything up, the sheer force of putting the lid on is gonna push everything down. By the time it gets to shipping, it's going to be completely flat as a pancake. So you don't have to spend, you don't want the crinkle to be going over all your products like this, because that's gonna stay. But you don't have to worry about crinkle being kind of up on the sides. Shipping is gonna take care of that itself. So I hope that helped. Thanks for hanging with me today. And I'm excited to see the beautiful boxes that you design. Bye.